Welcome to Darby ASMR. It has been far, far, far too long since I've spoken with you all, and hopefully you are just as supportive and loving as you've always been for me. I am so, so excited to this channel and to my hobbies. I've missed you dearly. These opening shots here are some footage of my brand new apartment that I'm very excited to share more with you. This year has been nothing but obstacles and achievements and changes and improvements. I have finished a few more quarters of school, got a new job, got a new apartment. Things are finally settling down. I am opening up to being able to enjoy myself and my time more, and so I would love to spend that time with you. So I'm going to make some coffee and let's have a chat. To hopefully hear from all of you again and share my new life updates and new ideas and hear how your year has been and how next year is planning to go so far for you. I have a lot of ideas and hopefully you can help me facilitate. ones should come next, which ones you're most excited for, and maybe you have some ideas that I haven't even thought of yet. So I would love to hear them. I would really, really love to give you a tour of my new studio apartment. I am so proud and excited. This is my first time living completely on my own. My first time where only my name is on the lease, no co-signer, no help. I've done it on my own. I never knew if a studio apartment would ever be what was right for me, but so far, a few weeks in, I am loving it. I'm getting it situated, and it is not a small feeling as one might think. I would love to give you a tour, show you how I am fitting everything, how I am making the living space feel spacious and separate, how I accommodate guests when they come over, and how my bunnies are adapting to the new space. I do live right near several parks. They've already gone outside in their first snow this winter, which is kind of amusing because it isn't even winter yet officially, but it started snowing here in Chicago on Halloween. So I bet there's lots more snow to come. I did truly love my first fall here in Chicago. I have some videos and some pictures and some stories that I would love to share with you if you're interested. I also got my very first fake Christmas tree. I had a fake one growing up as a kid, and it was one of mine and my siblings' favorite part of the holiday to pull it out of its old busted up box and separate all the colors and hook in all the branches, spread them out, and set up the tree. So now I have my very own. As you can see, I had set it up and strung some lights, but I do have some more lights, some white snowflake lights that I want to add. I also bought a few ceramic and bead ornaments that I'm going to make with friends and add to the tree. And I would love for you to join me making them and decorating. I have plenty of holiday ideas planned, so hopefully you stick around and enjoy them. I've also been practicing my accents and my makeup to do some role plays for you all, because those have been my favorite types of ASMR videos on YouTube for quite a while now. Tried my hand at a couple amateur roleplay type videos, but I've mostly done trigger videos in the past, and I really do want to move more into roleplay. Let me just show you those ceramic ornaments and bead ornaments that I am hoping to make with you in a future video. People that worries when they see something broken in a store that nobody's gonna want to buy it. But I do. I am very excited to paint this elf. I have plenty of paint. I've made my fair share. Homemade tapestries. I buy a twin-sized or full-sized, depending on the size of tapestry I want to make, sheet from Walmart or Target. I buy black or white or gray or whatever color I want my backdrop to be. And then I use fabric paints, and I paint on, I've done skylines, those are my favorite. I did one for New York City, and I did one after I moved here to Chicago. So those are my favorite types of tapestry. tapestries. Maybe it's because it's one of the only things that I can paint. But I've also done a sunflower field for my sister once. I can do just different types of, I guess, nature, just outdoor place and setting type paintings. Let me know if you would like that to be an idea as well. If you would like me to paint a tapestry, let you see the progress of it here on my channel. I don't know if that would be relaxing for you, but I could always give it a shot and see how you feel. Next, I have this pink one. I think he is adorable. He'll be even more adorable once I've got him painted. So I currently do not have any ornaments on my tree. But you have to start somewhere, and as the years go on, I will accumulate more and more and more. Until I have an ornament, or until I have a tree full of ornaments. Finally, I wanted to put a time marker on when I got this tree and when I first started collecting ornaments for it. So, this one just says 2019. Little mistletoe in the corner. Which I love. So those were the ceramic ornaments. I will now show you the beaded ones. After I take sip of that coffee that I made you watch me make. Pipe cleaner and little assorted beads. I think they would be very fun to make. I will probably make a lot of great sounds for a relaxing holiday themed video for you all. So those are the ornaments that I got to start out my tree. If you have any ideas for ornaments you would like me to add, let me know. I do want to try and find something unique that is bunny themed, because again, I have bunnies. I've had my bunnies since I was a very young child. They've moved around with me my whole life and I love them a lot. I would love to introduce you to both of them really quickly. Okay, this is Iris. He only has one eye. This is the side of him with an eye. Thank you. He kisses. I love his beautiful little eye. This is the side of him that no longer has an eye. He was born with a parasite in his head. I was told that he had potentially up to 1 year to live if I didn't remove side and have the parasite removed and the blood that was building up against his brain drained. So of course, I had the surgery done. As devastating as it was, he was only just a baby. Now he's a full-grown rabbit and has lived many years past having that eye removed. And he is healthy and happy and incredibly energetic. And you would never know that he is blind on one half of his head. His name is Iris. I named him long before I knew about the eye. But a lot of people do think it's kind of ironic. And this is Tansy. He is a larger breed of rabbit. So he is a bit bigger. As you can see, he is very restless. He loves to perch on my shoulder, which I think is kind of adorable, but now I have to scoot over by the couch so he can safely jump off and run away and go back to whatever he was doing before. Because he clearly doesn't want to be hanging out with me for this video. Say hi, Tansy. Thank you so much for sitting and chatting with me and meeting my rabbits and letting me ponder over my ideas and talk out my thoughts with you. Also, thank you for taking a sneak peek into my new apartment. I would love to show you more as I make it more cozy and homely as time goes on. I look forward to spending a lot more time with you in the future. Thank you for your patience and support. I hope, as scattered as this video was, that it still brought you some peace or maybe just some background noise while you work on something important to you. See you soon.